So are we ready to crack on? Well, we've got our next act, our next two fantastic performers coming to join us. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into Stevie's Lounge, it's Chris Difford and Norman Lovett. Now, this is, let's just say, I have to say, this is quite a unique pairing, the two of you. You have to explain the background and the two of you, well-known artists, coming together.
Well, it is a very unique coming together. I was doing a solo show in London, and Norman came along. I hadn't seen him for like 15, 20 years. And I asked Norman to get up and do some jokes, which he did, and next thing we know, we're in love again.
So are you pals of old, Norman? I'll skip round here so we can see you.
Yeah, we met in the 80s, I think, was it? At the Tunnel Club, the notorious Tunnel Club in London that Malcolm Hardy rang. And Jules used to come along, Chris, and they liked the comedians. I think there's always been a thing between comedians and musicians. They sort of have a little mutual respect. A lot of comedians want to sing, don't they? Not me. I know my limits. I don't want to sing, but people like Frank Skinner's always going on about singing and playing football, isn't he, and stuff. Well, I actually played football. I don't think Frank Skinner hasn't got the build for it, has he? I mean, just ridiculous. I'm not feeling in a very beneficial mood today. Sorry, I'm feeling bitchy. I think the weather. I don't know what it is. I used to live in Edinburgh. I lived in Edinburgh for 12 years. My daughters were born here, so I should have an affinity, shouldn't I? But it's. I've never been here. We never came here.
Never been to Fife.
Fife. Well, I knew Jack Vetriano. Mm-hmm. You know, he lived there. Yeah, I got to know him in his early. Sorry. Oh, that's right. Yeah, Jack. I met him. My wife met him before he became, you know, sold loads of paintings all over the place, and a few people in the art world weren't happy with him, were they? Because he was self-taught, I think, or perhaps what he was painting. I don't know. I haven't gone into that, but I know my wife actually helped. She modelled a couple of things with him before she started. But there was another woman who, in the prostitution trade, I think, was the model that he used quite frequently for a lot of his paintings.
Anyone know where this is going? Anyone?
I don't know. I've just got to watch it now. I think let's move on now. It's turned nasty, isn't it?
Drich, as we say.
Drich. And the har has...
It's coming. Oh, there we go. That's not the har. That's just one of the guests.
I thought the har comes to Edinburgh every year as well with the comedians, doesn't it, if they're funny? terrible pun. Puns. I hate puns, and I hate jokes usually, so I don't know why I said that.
Let's speak to Chris over here just for a second. Chris, I'll dance around here again. Tell us something, just very briefly, within the show that you do with Norman, does it contain a lot of songs regarding Squeeze? Does it tell the sort of story and your sort of journey?
It's a story basically of how I stole 50p out of my mum's purse and formed a rock and roll band called Squeeze with a guy called Glenn Tilbrook. And it's about the first part of our career up to the fifth album, and Norman plays a very big part and comes on stage and breaks up the monotony of me singing, I guess. And Dory Jackson is on stage with us singing, and it's a wonderful hour. It's been a great discipline to work within an hour's show. You know, normally when I'm on stage with Squeeze, we can go anything up to 2 hours, which frankly is far too long.
Well, it depends. I'm a big Squeeze fan, so I can happily sit through. I saw you at the Playhouse many years ago, and what was the story with Squeeze? Because it's been a sort of ever changing, obviously yourself and Glenn are the sort of stables of the band, but it's been a sort of, you know, constantly changing sort of number of members.
It is. Well, we've been in America recently on the tour. And we're back doing a tour October, November of this year. We're meant to be recording some new songs. So over and beyond that, I'm not quite sure. But it's been great being up here in Edinburgh. The festival is always a wonderful thing to attend. And I must say, being in someone's front room is rather brilliant. I feel like kicking my shoes and socks off and watching a telly.
And it's a big telly, I have to say, if you do feel like doing that.
So was it nicked in the riots?
The riots of Kinghorn. I don't know if they quite were the same as what we're experiencing down south. Yeah. So what we're going to do is we're going to hand over to Chris and to Norman, give us a little taster of the show that's running at the festival this year. Ladies and gentlemen, Norman Lovett and Chris Difford.
Yeah. Ready to go? Are you ready?
Yay!
What would you like us to do?
Up the junction.
Up the junction? Well, as a request. I haven't got the words here, but I'm sure we'll get by. Never thought it would happen with me and a girl from Clapham out on a windy common. That night I ain't forgotten when she thought out the rations with some or other passion. I said, you are a lady. Perhaps she said, oh, maybe. We moved into a basement when thoughts of our engagement. We stayed in by the telly, although the room was smelly. We spent our time just kissing, the railway arms are missing. Love had got us hooked up, and all our time it took up. I got a job with Stanley, he said I'd come in handy, and started me on Monday, so I had a bath on Sunday. I worked 11 hours and bought the girl some flowers. She said she'd seen a doctor and nothing now could stop her. I worked over the winter, the weather brass and bitter. I put away a tenner each week to make it better. And when the time was ready, we had to sell the telly. Late evenings by the fire with little cakes inside her. This morning at 4:50, I took a rather nifty down to an incubator. With 30 minutes later, she gave birth to a daughter. Within a year or longer, she looked just like her mother. If there could be another. And now she's 2 years older, her mother's with a soldier. She left me when my drinking became a proper stinging. The devil came and took me from bar to street to bookie. No more nights by the telly, no more nights snappy smelling. Did you see my car getting nicked outside your house? Alone here in the kitchen, I feel there's something missing. I beg for some forgiveness, but begging's not my business. She won't write a letter, although I always tell her. So it's my assumption, I'm really up the junction. Na 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 na. Everybody. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Thank you very much. Yep, there's only one wheel left on my car outside, so it's just like being in South London for me.
Would you do Cool for Cats?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Just to finish off, yeah? And because the cats have been part of the show, after all, so I think that's only fitting. Cool for Cats, everyone!
You have to join in, of course. The Indians hit signals from the rocks above the past. The cowboys take position in the bushes and the grass. The score is with the couple, she is tied against a tree. She doesn't mind her language, it's a beating she don't need. She lets loose all the horses when the corporal is asleep. And he wakes to find the fire's dead and arrows in his hat. And David Crockett rides around and says, it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats.
For cats.
Not bad, eh? The Sweeney's doing 90 cause they got the word to go. To get a gang of villains in a shed up at Heathrow. They're counting at the fivers when the handcuffs lock again. They're in and out of once a fifth and numbers on their names. It's funny how the missus always looks a bleeding same. And meanwhile at the station there's a couple of likely lads who swell as your father and they're very cool for cats, a cool for. To change the mood a little, I've been posing down the pub. On seeing my reflection, I'm looking slightly rough. I fancy this, I fancy that, I wanna be so flash. Give a little muscle, spend a little cash, but all I get is bitter and a nasty little rash. And by the time I'm sober, I've forgotten what I've had, and everybody tells me that it's cool to be a cat. It's cool for cats. Normally at this bit of the song, Norman Lovett comes on stage, surrounded by dry ice and mystery, and tells wonderful jokes. But to get a taste of that, you'll have to come to the show at the Gilded Balloon. 9 o'clock every evening until the sun goes down. Shape up at the disco when I think I've got a pawn. I ask her lots of questions as she hangs onto the wall. I kiss her for the first time and then I take her home. I'm invited in for coffee and I'll give the dog a bone. She says she likes the disco, so she's always on a run. I said I'll see you later and I'll give her some old chat. But it's not like that on the TV when it's cool for cats, it's cool for... King Horn.
Chris Difford, everyone. And the lovely Dory. Thank you very much. Can we do Labelled with Love? No, that's fine, that's fine. Chris Difford, everyone. What's that like, Chris Difford? Chris Difford singing in your sitting room. What's that about? Well, there we are, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks very much for coming. Stevie, thank you very much for letting us have your house for this, the final Front Room Fringe for 2012. Have you enjoyed yourself today?
Yay!
Got to carry on drinking?
Yeah.
Into the wee small hours, yes. You're almost dry. You're squeezing that can dry there. Christ, how long ago I'm going to get in the fridge? I don't want to appear rude. But listen, thank you very much. It's been a real treat for me. I think every single act tonight has been absolutely fantastic. A round of applause for all our acts. Standing out in the hall, all standing out very politely in the lobby there.